pollinated by creatures like moths and bats and flies. You might be thinking to yourself, hey, what a couple of cats are in my bedroom, and they would never bloom with pretty pink flowers. Echinopsis cactus flowers actually bloom overnight and then last for a full day only. In fact, they're usually at their most beautiful for a couple of hours. Both of the echinopsis in this beautiful clip were recorded over the course of approximately 8 hours of change. Flowers open and bloom. You can encourage your cacti to bloom simply by taking special care of them. That means making sure they're kept in a bright location with adequate sunlight and remembering to water them regularly enough so that it doesn't dry out too quickly. It takes a lot of energy for plants to produce flowers, so even an extra nutrient like special fertilizer will also help to encourage blooms. If you're a self-confessed lazy plant owner, your hardy cacti will likely still survive if you don't take these extra precautions, but you might not see a bloom. Thankfully, Echinopsis Screen is here to document all those beautiful blooms for you. Ever taken something out of the freezer to find it frozen solid and covered in icicles? It's not just forgotten quarts of ice cream that suffer those frosty fates. Just take a look at this Lockheed F-117 Nighthawk Stealth Fighter Jet frozen in ice. I know what you're thinking. There isn't a freezer big enough to hold a fighter jet. Well, behold the McKinley Climactic Weather Testing Laboratory. Try saying that 5 times fast. McKinley Climactic Weather Testing Laboratory. McKinley Climactic Weather Testing Laboratory. It may not cross the line, but it's and extreme weather in real ecosystems would be very expensive and unpredictable. To get around that problem, back in 1940, the U.S. Air Force built an engineering marvel, a weather laboratory capable of simulating various planets. The McKinley Climactic Laboratory is an insulated refrigerated hangar that's been operating since 1947 when the U.S. Army Air Corps began testing warbirds there. A few years later, it opened its doors to the rest of the military, and in the 1980s became accessible to private companies. The primary purpose of the lab is to measure the performance of aircraft parts and other military items at extreme temperatures. While inside the lab, the aircraft is supported and tied down, so the wheels don't move, but the
Calidonic's toothpaste helps stop TV on the screens, more often than the toothpaste. The dual gums bleed in the